Words are not the craft of the poet, they're the obstacle. Trying to express the ineffable. They're clumsy things, approximations at best. Words? How are we going to talk about this week? You can't. It's a felt sense, it's a gnosis. It's what we know. But ultimately, the words don't matter because people can read the language of our knowing. They can feel it, and that's the only thing that matters. I remember for 12 years, I came home and I talked to my parents about the psilocybin journeys and the ayahuasca journeys and all of the journeys I had, and I was so excited. I was like, you guys gotta do it. And they're like, nah. And one day I came back quietly from a Wachuma journey with Don Howard, and I just hugged him and I just smiled and I just laughed and I was just light and free and transformed. And all of them were like, we gotta go. Why? Because words are clumsy things. And that desire, that reaching, is naturally going to cause a retraction. But the invitation of our essence, of our being, of who we are embodied in our divine feminine, connected to our sacred masculine, that is what inspires change. That is what creates the impact that we're seeking to create. So don't worry about the words. Don't worry about how you're going to explain this to people when you go home, what you're going to say. You don't need to say anything. Just give them a hug. Whoever they are, just give them love. Love, 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 love. And they'll feel it when they're ready. And that's their time. And if they ask questions, well, then maybe the words are helpful. And maybe it comes, because then you can align the mind to what the body knows and what the body feels. And perhaps you can lead them by the hand into the orchard of mango trees. Say, here, we found it. Community, something we lost a long time ago. But we found it again. And not only did we find it, we found the way to create it, which is far more important, because this tribe evolves and it changes. Every different trimester, new people in, new people out, but this feeling is always the same, because it's the method, it's the way. And the way is far more important than the articulation, the effect. This isn't the days where there's a velvet rope around a certain group of people and nobody can get in and everybody's there and everybody's looking on the outside. That just creates enmity. That just creates jealousy. This is all open-ended. People will flow in, people will come out. And as you hold this space, that land zone, grounded to the earth, connected to the sky for your community, this will form there too. And they will take that and seed it elsewhere. And this is what changes the world. To know the self in another. To know another in the self. That's what we're here for. And when we all know each other as self, and we all know ourselves as each other, and the mother, and the father, when we really know that, well, then everything will follow naturally, because all of the things that we see, everything we look out, it's all delusion. It's all because of fog, of lies and stories that have gone awry, have clouded people's vision. They're not doing it on purpose, they just don't know. Forgive them, for they know not what they do. Really, though, forgive them, for they know not what they do. So what is our job? To punish them for not doing what they didn't know what to do? With our judgment, with our removal of love, with our castigation? Or is it to show them the way? To hold our hands like this. Say, come with me. I'll show you. I love you. That's our invitation. So I know many of you are wondering how to keep this going when you go back home, and how to maintain this. Well, this is within you. And these connections, I promise you, they're not going anywhere. They're here. And the gatherings will happen and the connections will form, but just lean in. You felt it. And when you felt it, there's no going back. So don't worry. And the way I think about any type of integration is, right here we stoked a giant bonfire, a huge bonfire where all of us threw our leaves and threw our shadows and threw our pain and threw our joy and threw our laughter and sometimes threw our clothes at the side of the pool into the fire. We threw it all into a giant bonfire, and it was raging and beautiful and bright. And we all get to take a little bit of that fire home with us. But naturally, that fire will start to go out. But we can always keep an ember lit. We can always tend that fire. That fire of what we know, the fire that awakens inside our body, the fire that we all awaken, that felt sense, that gnosis of who we are, what we are, how we serve. And just keep that ember lit. And with a few breaths, with a choice, with a dance, you can blow that back into a flame and continue that process, continuing to keep the ember lit always, always. So you're just one breath away and a little bit of kindling from starting that fire again. And then there'll be more gatherings and more bonfires, but you'll always have that ember because that ember is yours. It's not anything that we have. It's not proprietary. I don't have patents on it. You get to keep it and share it for everybody. That's the medicine for the world. I love you all so much. It is my life's honor to be able to serve with each and every one of you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
You are at the wrong place at the wrong moment. That's a hard one to accept, that this is perfect. Perfect? Perfect, you say? How dare you say this is perfect? Do you know what suffering I've been through? Perfect. Perfect? Do you realize what's happening to the rainforests? Perfect? Perfect. No. We may lose the humanity on Earth. Perfect. Perfect? You see the problem? You see where the mind clings?